Hello everybody. Today I'm going to show you how to make your own little pyrolysis kiln to make small amounts of biochar, to make bone char, to render plastic into oil. Only certain kinds of plastics, no chlorinated plastics. And other types of heating of things. You can actually take, copper assemblies or different types of metals and things, and you can get them up to a high temperature inside of this in the absence of oxygen, and then you can do operations on them when they're hot later on, like different types of reduction reactions where you could remove oxide from something. Okay, and so this is all made out of stuff you get from the hardware store or the sporting goods store and or. So what we have here is, first of all, we have a turkey fryer. This is like for deep frying turkeys. It's the type of burner that's used for camping, deep frying turkeys, etc. The important thing that this has to have is a variable regulator, so you can make the flame higher or lower. It has to have a little red knob on here or some kind of a way of adjusting it. Not all of them have that. Okay, what we have here is we have our reactor. Inside of it, we have our reaction vessel, which is just a standard 1 gallon paint can and a lid. This lid has a bulkhead fitting, which is just a feed through basically, and a compression fitting and some copper tube that represents our condenser. This is what actually takes the hot gases and condenses them back down into liquids. We're going to use this for turning plastic into lamp oil. So, and this is the lid of the 5 gallon paint container, as you can see here. It's been insulated and reinforced with a little bit of cement board, which is normally used in bathrooms for showers and things like that. It's water resistant, but it's also very heat resistant. So, and this is the probably the more complicated part of it here. And this is a 5 gallon paint bucket. And inside of it, we've insulated it with cement board. They're just held in with drywall screws. And down at the bottom there is just a plate of steel that is designed to spread the heat around. We have a hole in the bottom here. This goes right over the burner. Flame hits this spreader right here and then goes around it, thereby imparting the heat evenly around the outside of the reactor vessel, also known as a 1 gallon paint can, and the bottom of it, being that spreader there, has some structural integrity even when it's red hot, so that keeps it, normally the 1 gallon paint bucket is so thin that it may sag or distort and do bad things under all that heat. So this keeps it all stable. And so there's the top of it there. This goes on top, right over top of the burner. This is our reaction vessel. Inside of here you'd put whatever you want to pyrolyze, plastic, bark, bits of wood, anything you want, bones. Put it inside of here like that. Put the lid on it. In 1 gallon. Tamp it down so it has a very good seal. Of course, you want all the gases to come through the condenser tube. Put a top on there like that. Piece of wire to hold it on, like that. And this is a pan to collect the condensate, which is going to be the wood gases and the other byproducts of cellular metabolism, wood vinegar, methanol in case of wood, or if you're turning plastic into oil, it is going to be the actual condensed oil. So there you have it.